Good morning to all of you students. Today we are going to start the load balancing concept second part. Okay, earlier we have seen the bent end done, how to calculate the direct stresses at bottom fiber and top fiber of the beam when point load is there and when we have provided the tendon as a bent end done. Today we are going to see when tendon is provided with the parabolic profile. Okay. Why we have to provide tendon as a parabolic profile tendon? Okay, what are the advantages of providing the tendon as parabolic tendon? Okay, and how we are going to calculate the stresses at midsection, at extreme top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam, that we are going to see today. Okay, just I am going to repeat that what we have seen up till now. So initially we have considered one tendon, one beam where tendon is placed centroidally. Okay, along the centroid axis, and by providing the pre-stressing force, we have calculated the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. Second thing, when tendon is provided with some eccentricity, we have calculated the stresses at bottom fiber of the beam and top fiber of the beam. And that part can come in the stress concept. Okay, you people know that there are three basic concepts in pre-stress concrete. That is stress concept, load balancing concept, and strength concept. Okay, so these two parts covered in a stress concept. Okay, and when we are going to see the load balancing concept, last lecture we have seen that for point load, if you are going to provide tendon as a bent, okay, in that case it will give advantage for us by due to the inclination of this tendon, there are vertical two components are going to generate and that going to counteract this total load W point load, so intensity is going to reduce. And ultimately the stresses are going to reduce also. So that we have considered in the load balancing concept. And today we are going to see load balancing concept when tendon is provided with the parabolic shape. Okay, not bent here like this, we are going to provide the tendon. Okay, and why we are going to provide tendon like this? Because when the load condition is changed, now suppose beam is subjected with the heavy uniformly distributed load. Okay, heavy UDL load, in that case the beam is going to bend like this. Okay, beam is going to bend, see, I will show you, beam is going to bend like this. Okay, and due to this what happened, bending moment is going to increase at center. Now to reduce this bending moment due to the external load, what we have to do, systematic way we have to develop the internal stresses so that those stresses are going to counteract these stresses due to the external load. How you can do that? So for that, if you are going to provide tendon as a bent tendon, what happen if you are going to provide tendon as bent tendon, if you are going to stretch the tendon initially, if you are going to cut the tendon, so the upward pressure due to this parabolic tendon is going to generate it, and this is going to counteract, okay, this loading. So this is WC load and this is total W load, so net W we are going to get, that W will be W minus WC, getting? So this W minus WC, so this W is UDL, okay, external load on beam, and what is WC? This is pressure, okay, or intensity, or that UDL is generated by this parabolic profile of the tendon, because of, by providing this tendon, the resistance of this tendon, okay, if you are going to cut the tendon, this is trying to come upward side, and this is going to counteract this W, and that's why total intensity of UDL is going to reduce. Similar way here, how we have calculated the net P, so net P we have considered W minus 2P sin theta. So net W we have got like this, because we have considered this P sin theta. Okay, so total here that intensity we have reduces due to by providing tendon in a bent shape. Now here load pattern is different, here is not point load, because the bending moment, if I am going to consider one beam, simply supported beam having the point load W, so bending moment diagram for this will be like this. This is WL by 4. Okay, and if I'm going to provide the UDL on the beam, any beam, okay, for simply supported beam, the bending Venn diagram will be like this. So this is WL square by 8. WL square by 8. So the way, why we have to provide the tendon various shapes like bent tendon, parabolic tendon, because due to the behavior of the bending Venn diagram. As we have seen, the definition of pre-stress concreting, that the pre-stressing system is system in which we have to develop the internal stresses in a beam in a such a manner that, so those stresses are going to counteract or counterbalance the external stresses. That is main aim of the pre-stress concreting. So that's why initially we have to know which type of loading on the beam, and that type of tendon profile we are going to provide. Okay, so this is loading pattern here, UDL, heavy load is there. In that case, we are going to provide the parabolic tendon. Okay, what happened in parabolic tendon? Already I have told you, due to this upward pressure is going to generate due to this tendon. Okay, and that going to counterbalance this contract, this external UDL. Okay, so if I am going to consider now how to get the value of this WC, this upward pressure value. So here I am going to tell you simple thing, that moment formula you know for simply supported beam, WL square by 8. Okay, if I am going to consider the W here, WC into L square by 8, and if I am going to consider P into H, moment is P into H. Why I am considering P into H? So H here I am going to consider the dip of the tendon. The dip of the tendon. Okay, so if I am going to consider this as a H, so this is X, here I am going to consider PX is nothing but equal to P. So this P into H will be the moment, this H and this P will be get the moment. So I am going to, I have written here P into H. So W into L square by 8. So if I am going to get value of WC here, so WC I will get 8 into P into H into L square. Here P is a pre-stressing force, H is the dip of the tendon, dip of the central distance of the tendon from top fiber of the beam at center. So this is H, okay, the dip of that tendon, and L square is the length of beam. So this is length of the beam. So this is how we are going to calculate the WC, okay, the pressure resistance due to that parabolic tendon. Okay, so now this is about the how we are going to get the value, and next thing, after getting that value, WC value, net UDL, we have to calculate by considering W minus WC. And after getting W net, we have to calculate the stresses. Okay, as usual, we have to calculate the stresses. For that, I am going to show you the one problem. One minute. See here, you can see this problem now. Analysis of pre-stress concrete beam, tendon with parabolic profile. So tendon with parabolic profile, here I have shown one beam, load on the beam W. This is dip of the tendon. WC per unit load transmit to the beam, this is going to transmit to the beam, and WC load per unit load transmit to the tendon. Tendon load is going to transmit like this upward side. Okay, and already I have told you horizontal reaction at each end of the cable. So this horizontal reaction, this is inclined. If you are going to consider the horizontal reaction, so WC into L square by 8H. So we have to calculate the WC, that is upward pressure. So that upward pressure is here WC 8PH divided by L square. Hence the parabolic tendon carrying a tension P will be provided an upward uniform distributed load of pressure. Okay, so earlier we have discussed that upward pressure is going to generate in the form of WC due to that parabolic tendon. So net downward loading on the beam is therefore equal to W minus WC. W is total UDL external load on beam, and WC is the tendon P provided an upward uniform distributed load of pressure. This was this value. Okay, so maybe I think that point is clear now to you people now. Okay, so we are going to move to solve the one problem regarding this. So this is a typical problem I have taken. So following figure shows the prestressed concrete being provided with a tendon having the parabolic profile. If the total external load on beam is 40 kN per meter on the whole span, calculate the extreme stress for the beam span section. For tendon carries a prestressing force of 1200 kN. So they have given prestressing force 1200 kN. External UDL load is 40 kN per meter. And depth of the tendon they have given 100 mm. And length of beam they have given 6 meter. So initial stage we have to calculate the cross sectional area of beam. So that is 400 by 600. So that 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 m square. Section modulus Z BD square by 6. So that value will be 2.4 into 10 raised to 7 mm cube. So span of the tendon is 6 meter. Deep of needle they have given 100 mm. You have converted into meter. So that is 0.1. So upward UDL provided by the cable. So this value we have to calculate. So that WC value here, 8 pH by L square. So 8 is constant into pre-stressing force 1200. Deep of that tendon is 100 mm, that is 0.1. Length of beam 6 meter, it is L square. So total value you have got here 26.67 kN per meter. So now we have to calculate now net downward UDL on the beam, because we have got this 26.67. Here I can show you this upward pressure due to this tendon. We have calculated this value. We have calculated 26.67. So this value we have calculated 26.67 kN per meter. Now you can see here, this UDL is going to act downward, and the pressure generated or load generated due to this tendon, okay, due to this parabolic profile, that is a 26.67. So we have to calculate the net loading. So net loading will be 40 minus 26.67. So this is how you are going to get net downward load, because this is higher value, this is lower value. So net UDL will be downward side. Okay, so you can see here that calculation, 40 minus 26.67, that value is 13.33 kN per meter. So for this 13.33 kN, we are going to calculate bending moment. See, earlier on beam load is 40 kN, but we are not designing this beam for the bending moment. We are not going to calculate the stresses for 40 kN per meter. We are calculating here stresses for 13.33 because of this 26.67, this moment we have got due to parabolic bending profile of the tendon. Okay, so you have to calculate the bending moment. So bending moment is this. So we have to calculate now direct stresses due to the pre-stressing force, that is direct stresses P by A. We have to put the values of pre-stressing force and the area. We have got the value here plus 5 Newton per mm square. Extreme stress due to the bending moment. So bending moment plus minus Z, because bending moment, beam is going to bend. This is downward load. Beam is going to bend like this. And if beam is going to bend like this, compression is at top and tension is at bottom. So for bending stresses, we have to calculate two values, plus and minus. So that's why here we have considered plus and minus. So this is M by Z here. Okay, moment. We have calculated the moment 59.99 kN meter. We have to convert into Newton mm. So it is 10 raised to 6. Section modulus we have to consider. And then this value is plus minus 2.5 Newton mm square. After getting these two values, we have to calculate the final stresses. So direct stress is this, bending stress is this. Addition of these two will be the final stress. So that is plus 7.5 Newton per mm square. And the final stress at the bottom of the fiber, here this is plus, this is minus. So top part in a compression, so that is plus in bending, and bottom part in tension, so it is negative. So total here 7.5 Newton per mm square. So and this here minus m by r, so that value is 2.5 newton per mm square. So this is direct stress, bending stress, and this is combined stress. Okay, so this is about the calculation of various stresses at the edges of the beam at midsection. Okay, when the tendon is provided with parabolic, the outcome of this lecture, you people should understood why we have to provide tendon is a parabolic shape. What is advantage of providing the tendon in parabolic shape? The advantage is that by providing this tendon, due to the resistance of this tendon, we are going to get the vertical pressure, and that vertical pressure is going to counteract this downward external load due to UDL. Okay, so this is main aim to provide the tendon. Okay, so today we are going to stop here. Next lecture we are going to see.